Intravascular lithotripsy for severely calcified coronary arteries. Intravascular lithotripsy uses acoustic pressure waves to modify calcium inside the blood vessels, increasing the compliance of the vessel and facilitates stent deployment. The device takes care of one of the important nightmares of an interventionalist, the calcified coronaries. Disrupt CAD was a prospective multicenter study for the regulatory approval of intravascular coronary lithotripsy. Optical coherence tomography was used to assess the mechanism of modification of calcium in a substudy. Primary safety endpoint of Disrupt CAD was freedom from major adverse cardiovascular events of cardiac death, myocardial infarction, or target vessel revascularization at 30 days. Procedural success was the primary effectiveness endpoint of the study. The trial had 431 patients enrolled from 47 sites across 4 countries. Freedom from MACE was 92.2% and procedural success was 92.4%. Mean calcified segment length was 47.9 millimeters. And mean thickness of the calcium was 0.96 mm at the site of maximum calcification. Multiplane and longitudinal calcium fractures were demonstrated in 67.4% of the lesions by OCT after intravascular lithotripsy. Thus, Disrupt CAD3 study demonstrated the safety and effectiveness of intravascular lithotripsy in facilitating stent implantation in severely calcified coronary arterial lesions. A smaller previous study had reported the real-world experience on shockwave intravascular coronary lithotripsy for calcified coronary lesions. Their report had 26 patients who had intravascular lithotripsy prior to stent deployment. 14 patients had acute coronary syndrome, 11 had stable angina, and in one patient it was prior to transcatheter aortic valve implantation. Angiographic success was obtained in all cases with no procedural complications. Half of the intravascular lithotripsy procedures were in the left anterior descending coronary artery. In 58% cases, intravascular lithotripsy was used upfront, while in the remaining cases, it was bailout after suboptimal initial balloon dilatation. In the acute coronary syndrome cases, 71% were for the perceived culprit lesions, while 21% were for staged percutaneous coronary intervention to severe non-culprit lesions. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.